There are few of us who have not, at one time or another, had the sensation of reliving an experience which is actually new to us. Indeed, so common is this phenomenon that among psychologists it has acquired a technical name. But there is, on record, one case of a man who actually was familiar with a world that was new and strange.
It was business that took George Lawton to England in the spring of 1914. But after he had spent a few days in London, he succumbed to the temptation to visit his friend, Paul Bixby, who made his home in the historic old town of York. Lawton had never visited York before. And so, almost as soon as he arrived, Bixby insisted on taking him for a long walk. He wanted most of all to show him the famous cathedral known as the Minster.
We're not terribly far from it now. I know you'll want to see it, George. You probably know it by the name of St. Paul's Cathedral. Is that how they refer to it in the States? I say, George, do they refer to it as St. Paul's in the States? George!
What? Oh, I'm sorry. I guess I wasn't listening.
What's the matter with you, old boy? You seem so, well, so distracted.
It's a crazy thing, Bixby.
This
feeling I have, as if everything around here were familiar. I could swear I've been here before. I'm absolutely sure I know this town. Why, I could find my way from one end of it to the other.
Don't be absurd, George. You couldn't find your way from here to the Minster. There are all sorts of twists and turns before we get there.
Well, I won't get lost. Watch me.
And with that, George Lawton started off ahead of his friend. So quickly did he move, and with such absolute certainty, that Bixby found it difficult to keep pace with him. Down winding streets he went, and through crooked alleys. And when at last he came to a halt, he was standing at the old west door of the Minster. And Bixby, coming up to him breathless from exertion, gasped,
"My thought! That's amazing! How on earth did you manage to do it?"
But Lawton was not paying very close attention to his friend. His eyes were fixed on a corner a half block down the street, a corner occupied only by a vacant lot.
Whatever happened to the inn, Bixby? The one that used to be on that corner down there?
There never was an inn there, at least, not that I can recall.
But there must have been, sometime or other. I remember it distinctly.
Later that afternoon, the two men sat in a dusty corner of the public library, huddled over an old map of the city. With eager fingers, they located the Church of St. Paul's. And then they followed the line of the street westward to the nearest corner. And there, they found a legend, written in very small script.
"Site of the Golden Ox. Famous old inn. Destroyed by fire in 1628.
And so George Lawton, who had never been to York before, found that he not only knew his way around the streets, but that he even remembered a building which had not been there for almost 300 years. Is it absurd to suggest that this was actually his second visit to York? That in some former life he may even have been a resident of the ancient city? Perhaps it seems absurd. And yet, what other explanation can be offered for this baffling mystery? A mystery incredible but true.